working more efficiently? Of course there's an app for that. Hey everybody, Mica here, and a couple of weeks back I asked on my Instagram if you guys wanted to see more regular videos from me because I had a ton of ideas, and a few of you did say that you wanted to see something on a weekly basis, so this is my attempt of doing just that. And on that same day on Instagram, a few of you did say that you wanted to see video content from me, which was kind of more, you know, personal vlog type thing, and while I'm still trying to wrap my head around how to exactly do that while still maintaining a teachable, learnable, actionable, you know, video for you guys. In the meantime, I thought that this would be kind of like just jumping off the rails of what I did previously about like the 8 habits that helped me get my life together, and kind of just giving you a kind of a sneak peek of what I actually use in my own life. So, you know, nothing step by step, nothing like a system, but just really, you know, things that I personally use because you guys seem to like stuff like that. So here we are. So while we aren't in the level of vlogging like a day in my life, this video is just like another sort of personal look into what I use day-to-day life. And this video is all about the 5 apps that I use to help me work more efficiently every single day. Also, like the title suggests, these apps are all for Mac. 4 out of 5 of these apps that I mentioned are Mac-only apps. But if you're a Windows user and you want me to do something like Windows alternatives for all the apps that I use, feel free to let me know, because I would love to, you know, look into that if that's something that you guys are interested in, and if you guys are actually Windows users, because that's actually something that I do not know about you guys. With that said, let's go to app number 1, LastPass. LastPass is a password manager that you can install on your computer and even your smartphone so that you never have to struggle with remembering your passwords for all your 100, maybe 1,000 of online accounts. And okay, I'm sure you don't have 1,000 online accounts, but if you did and you managed to remember passwords for every single one without repeating a single one, then you have my utmost respect. But in all seriousness, LastPass keeps all your accounts secure because you never have to repeat your passwords again when creating new accounts, and even make sure that new passwords that you create are secure using the built-in generate password feature. And when you sign up for a new account anywhere, LastPass will 99% of the time prompt you to add it to your LastPass vault. And I say 99% of the time because there have been moments where I find that LastPass forgets to ask for the prompt to add the password to like my vault. But you know, technology is not perfect, so that's okay. Also, if you save your passwords from different sites to LastPass, it will automatically put in your username and your password as long as LastPass is installed on your browser. The same thing with your phone. If you just like have it installed, the app will automatically prompt you for usernames that you might want to use for this or accounts that you might want to be using. You can also install it on Google Chrome, Safari, and I believe all major web browsers, so that shouldn't be a problem. Being able to securely log into all my accounts without having to remember different passwords has just made me more productive, not only by saving time, but also saving like the mental energy it takes to remember something. All you need to remember for LastPass is your master password, and the app basically does all the work for you with all your accounts across every single website that you might be a member of. You can also add other information and details that you want secure, including addresses, bank accounts, and even private notes for whatever reason you might need private notes for. I don't use LastPass for any of these, but just letting you know that that's an option. LastPass is a freemium app. There is a free version, but the premium version starts at $3 a month with additional features like encrypted file storage for files like passports, contracts, basically any other thing that you might want to keep protected. But I've been on the free app for years now and have encountered zero need to upgrade, so I'm pretty sure you'll get a lot of value from the free version as well. This is also the only app on the list that is available for both Mac and Windows, so kudos to you, LastPass. Now, I have to say, from this point onward, all the apps that I will be mentioning are not only just Mac-only apps, but they are also all apps that are included for free in a Set App subscription. And if you don't know what Set App is, it's essentially like a Netflix for Mac apps where you get access to hundreds of useful apps that cover just about everything you need. What I love most about it is being able to rent an app I might only use once or twice, but might not be willing to necessarily pay a one-time fee for. And many of the apps that I also use from my Set App subscription, whether I mentioned them in this video or not, are subscription-based, so I've been able to fully justify the $9.99 a month price tag. It's essentially the price of around 2.5 venti Starbucks fraps where I live, and depending on where you are, $9.99 might be even less than that. And before you ask, no, I do not compare the cost of everything to Starbucks fraps. I don't even support Starbucks, but just letting you know what I have to give up in order to keep my Set App subscription. And honestly, giving up 2.5 coffees every single month, it's really not that bad. But I'm digressing. Let's move on to app number 2, Paste Smart Clipboard. Paste is a smart clipboard app for your Mac, which makes it ultra easy to copy-paste all kinds of things, so you don't have to do an endless cycle of finding the thing you want to paste, losing it because you accidentally copied something else, and having to go back and recopy the original thing you wanted to paste in the first place. I use space to keep things I normally need access to on the regular, which for me are links to important pages on my blog, including blog posts themselves, brand colors I might use, and even things like links to my YouTube channel and typical video descriptions like templates and stuff like that. And other than being able to save and easily access things that I normally need, paste also keeps a history of all the things that you've copied to your clipboard for a given time. I have set mine to remember things for up to 24 hours, but you can set it to 2 days, a week, and even a month. Though, honestly, I'm not sure when you need access to something you copied a month ago, but hey, you do you. You can copy text, images, hex codes for colors, icons, and just about anything you're able to copy on a regular clipboard. And again, I have free access to this app because of my Set App subscription, but I looked up the price on the App Store and you can subscribe to Paste for 99 cents a month or $9.99 a year, and there is a 14-day free trial if you want to take this app for a test spin before making the commitment. App number three that helps me work more efficiently is called Workspaces. I briefly mentioned Workspaces in my previous video about 8 habits that got my life together, so if you feel like I have mentioned this app before, yes I have, thank you for paying attention. Workspaces is essentially a project organizer where you can keep different apps, folders, and specific files for like a specific project all in one workspace. So you can organize things by project or by a general task. So for example, if I want to work on a new pin design for my blog, for example, I will just simply summon Workspaces, pull up my pin designs workspace, hit start, and the app automatically opens all the applications, the files, the folders that I use for this project and for this task. This just saves me a lot of time having to look through files and folders, and even if you're already naturally super organized on your computer, Workspaces just brings extra productivity by making it even faster to access everything you need for specific projects without having to click through all these different folders. And just a quick note as well, as of recording this video, Aptorium, the creator of Workspaces, has recently launched the beta version of Workspaces 2, which is supposed to have a new UI and all these extra features that the original app was missing. I haven't personally tried it yet since I'm just waiting for the app to drop in my setup subscription once the beta phase is over, but if the original Workspaces tells me anything, it's that a second iteration will probably come out really well, so I'm very excited for that. The second to the last app that helps me work more efficiently is called Focus. In a previous video, I mentioned all the common distractions that keep us from doing deep focus work, which is really the kind of work that helps us truly move the needle and really get closer to our goals. And in that video, I mentioned that one of the ways to eliminate these distractions is actually making it as inconvenient as possible to access things like social media apps or entertainment apps or basically anything that we consider a personal distraction. And Focus does exactly that. It makes it very inconvenient to access things that are normally very distracting for you and keep you from doing deep focus work. You can program the app to block certain apps and websites on your computer for set amount of time and even on autopilot on a schedule. All you need to do is set times for when you want to be regularly doing deep focus work, set the app to start when your computer starts up, and you'll be all good to go. Of course, you're able to manually turn focus mode on, and if you have to override these settings for any reason, like maybe you need to take a short break, then you can do so right from the menu bar. A cute little feature that I like about Focus, especially when you do try to access these distracting apps, for example, YouTube, during a time when you're supposed to be focusing, it immediately takes you to a blank screen with a nice motivational quote on it. And I believe you can also add your own quote if you want, but I'm about using my time productively, so I'm not going to do that. And if you really want to challenge yourself with Focus, you can toggle their hardcore mode on, where you essentially aren't able to make any changes to your settings when focus mode is on. I personally haven't tried this mode yet. It's a little too hardcore for me, but like, let me guys know if you want me to like maybe challenge myself to do that for a week. I know that would be really interesting, and I think that would be such a big challenge for me because I personally like having a little bit more flexibility even when there's so much structure in my day. And last but not least, the final app that helps me work more efficiently every single day is called SlidePad. If you have been a longtime Instagram follower of mine, then you will know that I have talked about this on my stories once upon a time, but I'm really in love with this app, so I'm going to talk about it again. SlidePad is basically a slide-over window or browser for your Mac. So you can see me hover my mouse, my pointer, over at the side, and this little thing pops out. I personally use SlidePad to access my calendar, my email accounts, Trello boards, and other messaging apps that I might want to connect. And it's just really faster than opening a brand new tab and typing in whatever I need on the browser. One thing to note, this app does send you desktop notifications, but I just set it to allow calendar notifications instead, because you guys know me, I don't allow notifications from emails to disturb me while at work. You're also not limited to just the apps that I use on Flightpad as well. You can easily choose from a variety of apps that's already on the default list, and you can look for a lot of the apps that they are already integrated in or that they recommend that you add. But you can even go the extra mile and add whatever other website you want to include, like Facebook, for example. But you guys know I'm not going to keep Facebook on there, so I'm going to go ahead and remove that. I also know there's a lot more you can do to customize and make the most of Flightpad, but I haven't personally explored that since I'm happy using the app the way I'm using it right now. But in case you explore it to its full capabilities, I would love to know what you do to help make Flightpad even more helpful to your daily life. And that was my list of 5 apps that help me work more efficiently every single day. And before I end the video, I just want to say that the tools that you use for whatever it is, for productivity, for goal setting, they aren't as important as the systems, the mindsets, and the personal productivity system that you have for yourself. The tools that we use can only support us in our journey to be more productive, to be happier, to be healthier. So it's really up to you how you use them and how you make them fit into your life so that you can achieve your goals in a more productive, wholesome, holistic, and really balanced way. Basically, doing the work and showing up is all you. No app or tool in the entire world can help you get the results that you make without you showing up. So now I want to hear from you guys. Did you learn anything new from this video? Are there any apps that you're excited to try that you're probably going to download like right after this? Are there other apps that you use to help you work faster, to help you be more productive, that I should know about, that I should check out? Be sure to let me know. And again, if you are a Windows user and you made it this far in this video, first of all, thank you very much for making it this far and for accompanying me all the way through this. But let me know again if you want to see any alternatives. Just letting you know, if you do want me to do that, just be sure to leave a comment and let me know, and I will look into that for you. And also be sure to let me know if you want to see more videos like this. Do you want me to talk about more apps for different things, for different use cases and stuff? Do you want me to do a deep dive on a specific app and how I personally use it? Be sure to let me know. And that's it for this video. I hope you guys have a productive day, a productive week, and remember, the tools that you use don't really matter as much as the work that you do to show up for your goals and to show up for yourself. But until then, I hope you have a super productive, amazing week, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!